morning, friends.
Good morning, Miss McGrath.
We have an extra one, okay? To remember, so that's reading 12. When we're reading, we have to do it fine because Miss Minnie's group is working. So today, we are going to be working on another reading skill. We are going to be rereading the story, City or Country. What story?
City or Country.
Remember, this book showed us some things you might see in the city or the country. Turn and tell your partner, wait for the directions, one thing you see in the city and one thing you see in the country. You two girls can talk, you two boys can talk. Go, I'm gonna time you, you have 30 seconds, go.
In the city, I see houses.
Okay, bring it back in 3, 2, 1. Layla, what did your partner say?
She sees in the country animals.
Excellent, Naya. What did your partner say?
Yes.
In the city, they have buildings.
Chanel, what did your partner say?
He said they have in the country. They have a lot of animals.
Excellent. What did your partner say?
Alright,
get ready to do the spells without
being
A to C.
Get ready
to go. So sitting up straight and tall in 3, 2, 1. So today we are going to be talking about how to compare and contrast things. What are we talking about?
How to contrast things.
How to compare and contrast. How to what?
How to compare and contrast.
Compare and contrast. Your turn.
Compare and contrast.
Welcome, Italy. Please come join us. So, eyes on me. We made a brand new poster to talk about how to compare and contrast. So put your eyes up here. When you compare, you say how things are the same. When you compare, you say how they're what?
The same.
How they're what?
The same.
When you contrast, you show how they're different. When you can trash, you show how they're what?
Different.
Excellent. So what I did is I looked at pictures of a giraffe and a zebra, and I said, let me compare them. How are they the same? So I looked at, you're watching me. I looked at the pictures and said, I see that they both have 4 legs, and I know a giraffe is an animal, and I know a zebra is an animal, so that makes them the same. So I said, they are both animals. Words like both tell me I'm showing what's the same. Then I said, they are also alike because they have 4 legs. Excuse me, fold your hands, please. Then I said, well, I know how they're the same. Let me contrast them. Contrast. What does that mean again? Oh, when I contrast something, I'm going to show how they're different. Let me look how they're different. That's your giraffe.
All these words.
He seems really tall. And that zebra? He looks like he's a little shorter. I think they're different because one, the giraffe is tall, and the zebra is short. Let me see if I can find another way to contrast them. Well, they both have patterns, but he kind of has a striped pattern, and this kind of looks like crazy rectangle. You know what? They are different because a zebra is short and a giraffe is tall. They also have different patterns. Did you see how I looked at the pictures and I said, how are they the same and different? Did you see that? Everyone, did you see that?
Yeah.
I looked at, thank you, Leila. I looked at both pictures. And so when we're reading our story today, Chanel, sitting up straight and tall, sitting up straight and tall, you are going to be reading to compare and contrast the city or country. What are we comparing and contrasting?
The city or country.
right, the city and the country. That was my fault. The city and the country. What are we comparing?
The city or the country.
Excellent. So I'm looking to see you sitting straight and tall. Ready to get started. I'm going to be reading with friends one at a time. Remember, before you get started, I need your eyes on Miss McGrath one more minute. Let's see whose eyes are back on Miss McGrath. Just like Italy. Just like Taj. Your eyes should be back on me for one more minute.
Good.
This is what I want to hear today. I want you to listen to Miss McGrath and tell me what you hear.
Kristen, when one friend comes back to me.
Okay.
Yes, Amelia? I'm sorry, Clayton. Next time, okay? When Kristen gets back, right?
Tell me what you read.
Chanel,
there was nothing out of my mouth. When you were reading by yourself, that's how you need to be reading, so Miss McGrath can hear her friends. Got it?
Got it.
So let me see.
What word is this?
Can you start reading,
please? Yes.
Remember, when you see old people together, that makes the ow sound. What sound?
Let's see. Let's see. Let's see. Let's see.
Well, the B is not going to make any noise. What sound does it? Now put it together. Okay, now reread the sentence so you can do it with sliding your finger. I like how you fixed your reading here.
Yes, no, we've seen this word before. What word is this?
To help you, what letter sound do you hear at the beginning?
When I touch it, you say it. Get ready, go.
So now look at the picture to help you. What do you see in the picture?
Get ready, go.
Okay, so what is that called? Great job, silently reading, friends. So let's do that together. Use the part to charge. Does that make sense to be born?
Okay.
Why not?
Because born starts with me.
Okay, so what else do you see? Remember, what sound are we looking for? Okay, so do you see the picture that might have a sensi? Reading on your own. Make sure you keep sliding your finger like you are and sounding out those words. Great job. Hey, Shamil. Shamil, we got to read the story yesterday. So, Shamil, can you tell me one way the city and the country are different? Can you contrast them for me?
Because the city are the cars. The cities are the cars.
What in the story makes you think that?
Okay,
how does
street? There are lots of cars too.
Where does that?
Lots of cars.
Look at this word here. You're saying this is the word car. So does that make sense? What sound do you hear at the end of the word cars? Because listen to the word cars. What sound do you hear at the end? R's. R. Is that an R? Let's sound that word out. Does that sound like a word you've heard?
Cat.
Love how you fix your error. Hey, read it one more time. Start over and make sure you read the words on the page. How is the country different?
There's a lot of cats.
Wait, but
they have a lot of animals.
Excellent. I want you to keep reading in your head and tracking with your eyes. I love that skill, Jamel. That's showing you're improving in your reading. Excellent. Okay, Naya, are you ready? Naya, can you tell me how the country and city are the same?